this is a condition of before video. So here reproduction is done in two types, that is sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction consists of male part, say sexual reproduction is male part and female part. These are both are connected with each other to then that form zygote. That zygote is also can be due to the formation of a zygote by connection with the male part and female part, that is called sexual reproduction. And the in the after formation of zygote, it develops and it's give and it's and is converted into seed or any offspringes. And also it after the formation of zygote, it also can be converted into a new plant. So this is also by connection within the male and female part, the new organisms also can be produced, that is undergoes in the process of sexual reproduction. Another type of reproduction, that is also asexual reproduction. The asexual reproduction, that is also the birds and spores also can be undergoes in the asexual reproduction, and vegetative propagation and vegetable parts also can be undergoes in the asexual reproduction. What is about asexual reproduction? Without connection between the male and female part, that is to form another organism, that is new plant or any other type of a organism, that is called asexual reproduction. The birds, this type of budding also can be undergoes in the process of asexual reproduction. It also can be gives new plant, and spores also gives undergoes in the process of asexual reproduction. This also can be gives new plant, and the spores are like this. The structure is also can be gives and the undergoes in the process of asexual reproduction. It gives another type of a new plant. So this is the first of all single plant, and also it is doubled and triple, and next it increase their number of and plants numbers numbers. So this is also undergoes in the process of asexual reproduction. And also the asexual reproduction is also done in vegetable sources, that is also kind of vegetable propagation. The which parts are participate in this process? The roots, stems and leaves, these are also process undergoes in process, this are gives new plant. So these are all above belongs to the reproduction. This is overall lesson of the reproduction. Here what are important points of this lesson? In this lesson we are learning about cutting, androecium, crinoecium and thalamus, corolla and calyx, stamens, pistils, and what is about anther. And the name of anther is also can be called as pollen grains, and filament and budding, zygote and vegetative propagation, and spores, pollination and fertilization. In this lesson we are learning what we have learned about this lesson. Flowers consist of four parts, that is sepals, petals, stamen and pistils. Suppose this is the datura flower. So that is all flowers like datura flowers can be consist of four parts, that is sepals, petals, gynoecium, that is a female part of a flower, and androecium, that is a male part of a flower. Next, here the based on the presence and absence of a floral parts, flowers are can be two types, that is complete flowers and incomplete flowers. Based on the presence of both or single sexual part of a flowers are two types, that is bisexual flowers and unisexual flowers. That is, the flowers consist of both androecium and gynoecium. The flowers are can be consist of bisexual flowers. The type of flowers are can be called as bisexual flowers. The flowers consist of either gynoecium or androecium. That type of flowers also can be called as unisexual flowers. And transfer of your pollen grains from anther, that is transfer of pollen grains from filament of a stamen to stigma, that means female part of a flower, that is called as pollination. So the transformation of a pollen grains to the stigma of a flower, that is called pollen grains. So this transformation of a pollen grains to stigma of that flower, which are which are our participate in this process as an agent, like the white through a water. The water also can be transfers their pollen grains to the stigma of the flowers through some animals, some birds. The animals also can be transfers their pollen grains to the stigma of another flower, and through a water and through a air and some type of insects like bees. These are transfers the pollen grains to the stigma of the another flowers and some of the human activity. So that are agents, that is air, water, animals, insects, humans are the agents of your pollination. Next, here transfers of a pollen grains from another anther to the stigma is known as pollination. And however, can be self that is pollination also can be and can be considered of two types, that is self pollination or cross pollination. Self pollination is that pollen grains also can be connected with the stigma of a same flower, that is called self.